Okay, guys. Hi, my name is Reckless Squad. I'm starting to cook the dinner that I was going to cook. I'm sorry I had already started it before I turned the camera on. It's the trash. I cut up the cabbage. There's two of them. I put it in the pot already. And I still have a little piece of cabbage I have to add in once it cooks down. Oh, guys. Before you start watching this video, don't forget to subscribe. Definitely if you're new to the channel, don't forget to hit the notification bell as well. And give this cooking a thumbs up. Okay guys, and today I'm cooking cabbage, sweet potatoes. I'm cutting the sweet potatoes now. Macaroni and cheese. I'm gonna make homemade macaroni and cheese for the first time. And cornbread. So let's get started. Well, I'll restart the cabbage. Sorry about that. Marie, stop all the noise. You're going to see the kids in and out. I don't know that I can add the other cabbage that I have to go with it. So, okay. Where'd this show? Okay guys, I'm gonna add the hickory bacon, the natural smoke, instead of the salt pork. I'm just gonna add these thick slices of bacon into my cabbage. My cabbage was a lot easier, guys. I just seasoned it with, this is Himalayan pink salt. It tenderizes the cabbage. So, kind of like all over the place, so bear with me. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Amazon. Or a bottle of water, you know, I don't know. You rinse the sink back out, wash it back out again. Clean the sweet potatoes. Rinse the sink back out. But y'all know I keep dishwasher warm in the sink because I like to, have bleach in my water. And what I'm going to do now, I'm going to go ahead and add ingredients to my sweet potatoes and let it cook down and cook in it. I should have had these ingredients out already. This is what I add in the sweet potatoes. That's all I need. Because I like my potato caramelized. You know? Okay. I'm going to use a stick of butter. No, it's okay. I'm going to go ahead and use both of these. Use both of those. I use both of them. It was only 1 tablespoon off of that stick. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and add the sugar, guys. Take the bag out. I like the caramel lot. Check it out. Check it out. I'm sorry, I use all that. I like my sweet potato caramelized. I like to make my own caramelized glaze for the sweet potatoes. Make my own caramelized glaze. So I probably used a whole box of, I used a whole box of pure cane, golden brown sugar, 16 ounce. But that comes a lot of sweet. Turn this around. You were to season this chicken. I just cook regular, cook regular Jiffy mixed cornbread with it, you know. Got to season this little. Okay, I'm gonna like to put on my chicken. Chicken, where is that? Did he get it? She didn't get the... There you go!
I just have the noodle!
Just add a little to the sweet potatoes. Just a tad. Well, just add a tad bit of cinnamon to the sweet potatoes, y'all, which I really don't add them like that. I'm just getting just a tap. Tap of cinnamon. Okay, here's that kicking chicken, guys. What a fan going. I gotta get in front of it. Oh, you guys can't even see me. Thought you could see me. Okay. And I gotta get in front of the fan. The fan was blowing the season. Ooh, that's a lot. I don't think that's going on enough. More than enough. Falling on this chicken. I wish I would have been able to let it marinate. I'm telling you, when I turned the camera on, I had already started, guys. And I knew I was supposed to be doing this today. I knew it. I'm doing garlic powder. Because I really don't like to use a lot of seasoning. But seasoning got all that salt in. Powder doesn't. Could have been marinated all the while it was in the sink, right? Yeah, I know, I know. Told you when you turn that camera on, your mind just, you focus on that camera and recording. Hoping you got everything you need. Lift the skin up on this chicken with the skin, with the bones. Get that under there. You know, the skin be good when it's baked and crispy. And seasoned real good. Woo, that skin is good when it's seasoned, eh? So I'm lifting the skin on the chicken and putting the seasoning underneath it. Because I don't really have this much chicken left anyway, so I'm going to go ahead and use it all. I'm going to go ahead and use all of them, just a little left in here. There we go, it's all gone. Okay, let's put our garlic on here too. Oh, the fan blowing it. Instead of putting that fan. And the I wish I was thinking. What was sweet potatoes cooked.
be back up.
Okay, guys, the sweet potato is cooking after we start to run it on the my first time trying to bake a homemade macaroni and cheese. So bear with me, guys. Bear with me. Let me get a pot so I can glaze the get the cheese to melt. Dries it right away. I don't have to wait because, like this towel, if I constantly drop this towel, it gets damp and it's not really drying out. I do need the cutting board again. First time again, this homemade oven cooked macaroni and cheese. I'm normally that box girl with the crab. That's with the crab, with the sauce. Not the regular powder crab, no, the other crab. So, there we go, learning. I know how to cook it, but cooking a perfect macaroni and cheese. Thank you. And guys, I don't mess with nothing if it ain't butter. I don't have time, or I can't believe it's not butter. I don't mess with that. I don't mess with nothing if it don't say B-U-T-T-E-R. Mm-mm. Not the one. Not the one. I really don't want to put a lot of butter in here. I just want to put a little, you know, because I don't want it to keep that cheese off of the noodles. You know, if it's too, got too much butter on it, it won't, the cheese won't stick and get inside the macaroni to slice right off. We want that cheese to stay on. No. Okay. We got to take this board over here right along with us. Damn, guys. I got to bring this over here with me. Cheese to go on the top, you know. I didn't get it to go in with the cheese sauce. No, I just got that to go. The shredded cheese to go on top. Oh, I'm sorry, guys. The board is over here. Let me turn.
I keep forgetting.
Let's go. We're over here now. Let's go. We're right here on the floor. I don't know why I moved that board out of the way. I don't. I should have left the chopping board on the cabinet. Yet, guys, I haven't even bought the elbow noodles yet. What? To boil my noodles, it don't take long for noodles to boil anywhere.
I said, I ain't seen her put on the noodles.
Comment below if that was you saying that. Did y'all see her put on the noodles?
Oh, once I got the noodles on, I have to pause the camera until I boil the water for the noodles. But right now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to add another cup of milk. I didn't measure the first one. I was just worried about that, but I don't know I need more milk. And I added my 2 tablespoons of butter. I got a mess on the stove. Gonna ask, I'm waiting on it to really heat up so I can add the cheese. Get it to a little boil. By the time I get through with that, let me put the top on this. Top on this water so it can boil quicker. Yeah, let's add the top on the water. Make sure it's the water top. Yes. Water should be going for the noodles with everything. By the time I get through making the cheese, the noodles should be done. So what I need to do, what else should I do? Okay, these are the apple noodles I'm using, guys. Creamette apple noodles. I think I only need one box though. For this size anyways. It's not big at all. So I think I'm gonna need one. Wait. Oh, this is long. Turn those. And then I'll put it on an electric stove. The heat is different than a regular stove. Yes, I need to turn it just a little. Guys, and I'm gonna add a little salt to the water. Woo! About to get burnt up all over by the sweet potatoes. I said I'm about to get burnt up. I said I was burning. No, I said I was about to be burnt up by the sweet potato leaning over the pot. Like I see it melting on other people's, when they're making this cheese, it melts as they're dropping it in. This is not melting. I'm so afraid to turn it on high because I don't want it to stick. Okay, guys, we got the butter. Get these noodles. Look at me. Just look at me work. Cabbage about done. No, I don't take cabbage long to cook. But I've been at this for an hour already. I'm gonna put the salt in the water for the noodles already. Add those in. Rinse this right quick. Rinse this off from the sweet potatoes. Come back over here. Finish stirring this. Get on this, get these noodles so they don't stick. I'm staring to it one time and y'all just see this. Y'all go ahead. Go girl. Go girl. All this spice and all room for these noodles. Yeah. I've got plenty of enough room for the noodles. I'm not going to wear it right now. Don't worry about our cheese on here. But I'm kind of just taking this time because the noodles are ready to be done. Yeah, I'm just trying to take this time. About the cabbage and the sweet potatoes, you know, they cook on, you know, once you put them on the eye, they cook on their own, you know. You don't have to tend to them as much as you do like the cheese, but it's macaroni and cheese. And the chicken does its bacon.
Just
chair got to blow up on.
And you know, by putting them noodles in the oven, them noodles gonna finish cooking.
Yeah, they are.
But it's good to have that softness to them. I know. When you're doing it homemade. But they're so tiny, I don't know how far they're gonna blow up.
Okay.
How long they said these noodles hold? You know, these boxes be lying anyway.
Yeah, them noodles been boiling longer than 6 minutes.
They have them tender, they said 8, and I want them tender.
How they get them boiling longer than 8? See, my oven temperature is on the oven, so I don't see the time.
Oh, my microwave, I could have been watching.
Well, look at this cheese, y'all. Check the cheese out. Check it out. Look.
Y'all see that? Let me bring it to you. Look at that cheese, y'all. Come on now. You know it's ready for the macaroons. They got the cabbage still cooking, guys. It's the cabbage looking good. And they practically done on cabbage. Cabbage is another food that doesn't take very long. Sweet potatoes, they near done, y'all. So I'll show y'all those when those are almost done. Okay.
Okay, we're gonna add this cheese in.
Let's go. Could I split these macaronis up so that cheese can go down through there? Do some stirring up in here. Yeah, the stirring up in here. Gotta get it all over them. You wanna go all to the corners with it. Take it to the corners. See what I'm talking about? Take it to the corners, go across. Go all this cheese. Yeah. Don't that look good in cheese? Here we go, guys. We did it. I did it. It ain't done yet now. We don't know what it tastes like. It ain't done yet. So I can't say I did it. Because we ain't done yet. We got to put cheese on top.
Put the seasoning.
Put it in the oven. Okay, what seasoning do I want to put on my macaroni cheese? I know I want to put some, pepper on it, a little pepper on it. Cause I've seen a couple people just put pepper on it, pepper on top of it. Cause you know it's about the season. I seen some people put paprika in it, but I'm not trying to do that cause I got picky eaters that would. Hey guys, I'm just gonna put a little pepper on it. Where the pepper at? Just get us a little pepper here. Add to it. Fan blowing the pepper everywhere. See that cheese? Look at that. Look at that. That ain't no cheese, guys. Look. Ooh, wee. I'm gonna have to put this in the oven. Just imagine, guys. Putting that in the oven, getting that cheese on top to make it. Let's level it out here. Let's level it out here. Come on, let's go ahead. Level it out. So, my casserole dish was perfect for that one box of elbow noodles. I thought it was gonna be too many noodles. It was straight. Okay, let's add our Monterey Jack and a little of the shredded cheese on top, so cook it in. Just want it on the top, y'all, to make a beautiful top. It's gonna be good. Monique in here watching me too, guys. Cause I think she know how to make homemade macaroni cheese, but I haven't never made it, so I'm making it my way. Monique making her, cause Monique used, what you use Monique, that half and half? She used the heavy cream, guys. And I just used 2% milk, that's all. Let me move that. I didn't use the heavy cream. Because that's going across with this. Oh, that's gonna be so pretty, y'all. Easily put it across, I know. As well. Because I know this, yeah, this chopped cheddar, so we don't, that's why I added the Monterey Jack to it. Kind of like even out the flavor. Okay, that's it. I'm not gonna put much on top of that. At least I don't. That's how I'm finna do it, y'all. I'm making mine the way I make it. Okay, and what I wanna do, to get this cheese melted, I'm gonna put aluminum foil over it first for about 5 minutes, I think that was that I did. I'm gonna put it in the oven for about 5 minutes, and then I'll take the top off, and it goes on the top rack, I know that. And I'm gonna go ahead and finish it up. And I'll let you guys know the results when you get done. Okay, let's go ahead and add this guy to the oven. Get Aiden. I don't need Aiden to let this oven now. Go, baby. Go that way. Come here. That's why I need this oven now. It's already on 400. Come on, let's slide this in on the top rack. I don't know y'all can see me. Oh, yes, y'all can. You can see me. This is what I'm doing is on top rack. The chicken is also in here. Practically almost done. It'll be done in a minute.
Come here.
There we go. Let's get these dishes out of the way. I need to make my corn. Oh man. Oh, back on what it is. I don't know why this extra pan is out. I like to get the stove done, turned off, so the mess I made over here. Whew. Clean the cabinet off as well. You know? Cooking with Martin, be respectful today. Yes, you are. In her macaroni and cheese. Okay, guys, let me put these up. This pan I didn't use. What I'm going to do is make this cornbread. I'm making my cornbread in the cake pan, guys. Yes. Because it come out good in this. Like I said, I'm just making the original cornbread Jiffy. Okay, let's put this stuff up. Now let me get this cornbread. I don't have time to worry about that right now. I'm gonna wash these few dishes. That stuff to go in the garbage. Put it over there. Okay, it's gonna jiffy. Okay, like I said, the original jiffy. That's what I'm doing, 2 boxes. This finna be in line to get washed with the cheese pot. And what else? Oh, some knife hit the floor. I need to get up. Put it in the soup. Okay, now let's get this cornbread made. Yeah. I got 2 eggs out of the fridge. Now, Jiffy Mix, all you need is 2 eggs on here for milk. And this is done deal. Right, I'm way behind on making a cornbread. Hey, this is exactly what I need to have. If it makes. I love my chicken mix. Okay. Eggs. I only need 2 of them, so take the 2 out of the cart. Get the egg cart back. I can keep things in the water. Because the dish is going to get washed. Put the 2 eggs in, it's y'all seeing me. It's y'all seeing me. Not very, not a lot, but there you go. You should see me now. 2nd egg in. The box. Garbage. Milk. That's all the milk, y'all. That's all the milk. Serving spoon. The syrup and macaroni and cheese. And if I have to add a little water, I will. And I think I am, but oh, it's already down. A cup of water, y'all. And I don't think that little milk will be enough. Slow down, baby. You're doing too much. Slow down now. Slow down. You got this. You got this. You worry about time, so half this thing gonna get speeded up anyway. Slow your roll. Slow your roll. You got this. And for the cornbread, I'm gonna add my cornbread. I just add just a little oil in it. Why? Every time I close this, it just seems like it just takes all the money off my hands. Why is taking all the money in the world to get this oil open? And I'm the one closed it. Why is the dish towel all the way over here? Closed it. Oh my gosh. Just a little. Just a little. And then I add a little to the pan as if you was cooking a cake. Just add, I don't stir it around in the pan either. No. I don't do that. I just put it in and spoon, catch it. Yeah, I don't stir it around in the pan like I do for cake mix. No, I don't do that. I stir it around in the pan. Macaroni and cheese, top off of it, and let the macaroni go ahead and do what it needs to do. Already looking kind of watery here. I hope that didn't overdo it. You gotta come out. I don't have time for that. Yeah, and don't let it caramelize. Use this when it come out. Keep my little fork. Okay. Garnish. This time, you won't be hanging over it on the stove. I'll hang you, put you on the side of it because I don't want them to catch on fire. Let's check the sweet potatoes, y'all. Put this all up. Don't need no oil. I didn't really do oil like that. Don't put this up. Back into the cabinets. Paper towel there, it's just two paper cups. I leave them there. This one on the shelf. The salt. Room on the floor. Go back in this drawer. Okay, now let's get the washing these up.
Yes, you shall.
If I'm not mistaken, I think my, put these noodles up. Water's not as hot as it was when I first started. Then it really gets a little hotter. Yeah. It's heat to it. It's cool. It's cool, it's not hot, you know, like it was. So let the water bottle. Y'all, I think my cabbage is done. Cereal this morning. Yeah. I do this on my pasta bowl, you know. Add a little more stuff. Okay, turn it off. Got the water off because it's about to overflow the sink. I need that one. Caramelized right now. And I know it don't take long, so. Nope, they didn't get it yet. I got the microphone and cheese. Just one thing is on my mind, if ain't nothing else. Okay, because it's my first time doing it. He want a piece of cheese. Wait a minute, ain't no wash the dishes. Let me wash this dish out right quick. Okay, Granny gonna give you a piece. Just a sec, okay? Yes, you can have a piece of cheese. Let me give you a piece. Wait a sec. I'm trying to do something. I already got checked, y'all. Me, I don't like burnt food. Sports food either. Nothing more. Okay, guys, got the dishes out of the way. Okay. Maria, if you don't move that cup off that deep freezer, why you got it sitting over there? I'm trying to straighten up, but you in here putting other stuff around.
As I know, I like to
paper towel dry. You better get out that refrigerator, I tell you that much, baby.
What you need?
Because you don't need to keep eating that cheese, you're going to be stuffed up. I like my chicken crunchy too, so I know I'm looking at your chicken as well as everything else when it's sitting right beside them. Chicken. On the stove.
I'm gonna put
a
piece
of this one. This one. It ain't going nowhere. Go back there and put this one. Okay, guys, here's the chicken. You see the chicken? This is a chicken.
I'm gonna get it short to you.
Ooh, it's crunchy.
Curl.
Look at that crunch, guys. That's the thighs we cook.
With that chicken flavor. You can see the flavor.
Okay, let me turn these cabbage on.
They're also done.
I should have had the sweet potatoes on hard and I had them.
They look like a caramelized sweet potato. I love the juicy sweet potatoes. I like them caramelized.
Okay, I'm checking the microwave. Oh, it's starting to get brown around the edges. Cornbread down there cooking, so. Guys, I'm almost done. Whew, no, I want my macaroni and cheese caramelized and it's bubbling up, so it's all. Hi guys, Monique got the camera, so I'm gonna go ahead and take the macaroni and cheese out and let you guys see what we got here.
Woo-wee, it looks good.
Okay guys, come on over here with me. I got this down here so I'm gonna burn the cabinet. Oh, I see the pepper. Look at that, guys, don't that look good? Let me get the spoon. And show it to you guys.
What's it gonna do?
I'm gonna show them, get a little, put it in a... Okay guys, I'm finna take the spoon and get us some of this out of here. They take it out and they get what's on the side. They get what's on the side. I'm finna get what's on the side and let you see. You don't watch the films on it. Okay, my macaroni and cheese, guys. My homemade macaroni and cheese, first try. Margaret, be respectful. Let's give it a try. Woo! Okay guys, like I said, Monique got the camera. I'm taking out the cornbread, guys.
Ooh, check the cornbread out, guys.
Gotta make space for it. Oh boy, I need space for the cornbread, y'all.
The back eye?
Okay, I'll put it on the back eye. There we go. Let's turn this oven off. Castle. And we're done with that hot oven. Yes, Margaret, be respectful, guys. Look out for this. Hey. Let's get started. I'll let y'all see in the cabbage. Y'all see in the cornbread. Well, they probably don't start recording right now. All I'm waiting on is the sweet potatoes, y'all. Because I like mine caramelized. I like that. My juices that the sweet potato is soaking in, I like it to be caramelized, you know. So it'll be done soon. And I'll be back with you when it's done.